We're back, ladies and gentlemen.
Back for the second
round of the show.
Yeah. And like I said, we got Miss Norma Huguet with us from Century 21, who has some really cool listings. Before we get started with that, I want to mention the fact that I ran into Wilfred Kinnison and Roderick Smith, and they got a barbecue brisket. They barbecue brisket every week.
Sure enough.
If you want some good barbecue brisket, call Wilfred or Roderick at 337-693-7416. Or 337-232-9206. Good barbecued brisket. So I'm saying hi to Wilfred and Roderick. I ran into them at the store the other day. And Smoking Joe Frazier died. He was 67 years old.
Mm-hmm.
He knocked out Ali in the Thriller in Manila. I watched the fight.
Yeah,
I watched all
that.
Their fights back then. I used to love to watch Ali fight.
Yes.
I couldn't stand him. Because he was so arrogant and cocky, and he didn't serve in the U.S. military. But I tell you what, I love to see him fight. Man.
Yeah.
He was a classic boxer, and Joe Frazier knocked him out twice.
Yeah.
He beat him twice anyway. So our condolences to Joe Frazier's family. Saw Mickey Bellerman at a funeral home. I tell you, I hadn't seen Mickey Bellerman in years and years. And Ms. Del Buno died, Diane's mama.
Yes.
And Mickey was there. And at first, he said, Diane said, you recognize him? And I said, no. And he kind of had a kind of bearded and stuff. I said, Mickey. You know, I hadn't seen Mickey, I guess, since we graduated from high school.
Still
maybe. Yeah, it's been years. So but it was good to see Mickey, and we're going to have lunch. So Byron tells me he rides his bicycle. You know Byron rides, Byron Briggs?
Mm-hmm.
You know Byron.
Yes.
Well, he rides his bicycle all the time. And he's got one wheel in the front that's red. He got another in the back that's yellow. It's an old bicycle. So he rides it all the time. So he rides up to the St. Leonard Bank. You know, they got those electric doors.
Mm-hmm.
Byron rides a bicycle in the bank.
In the bank. Whoa.
All the tellers said, you can't park that bike in here. Get out of here with that. He said, well, I don't see a no parking zone. That Byron's hell yeah, boy.
He's got something in his head, boy.
He's hell when he's well, I'll tell you. Anyway, they said they're going to beat Obama with a cane. You heard that?
No, I didn't hear that.
Steve, let us see some pictures of Locke de Carlisle and some of the listings that we have with Ms. Norma Huguet. Folks out there, I'll let Ms. Norma explain, but here's some pictures. We got a subdivision with a beautiful, beautiful 12-acre lake on it. And it's rolling hills, and it's really pretty.
Yes,
Ms. Norma?
Yes, it's the gentle rolling hills. And there's acreage out there. The lots start out probably about a half an acre to a little over an acre. And they'll run anywhere from 20,000 to 85,000, depending what you choose.
Sure
enough. We do have some lots that that overlook the lake, but are not necessarily on the lake itself. So you can still have a view if you choose some of the larger lots.
Mm-hmm.
And of course, we have some good size lots over an acre on the lake side as well. It's beautiful out there. Trees,
yeah,
they have do
that.
Have
look
trees. There's pecan trees.
Yeah.
It's quiet. Mm-hmm. It's kind of tucked away in a wooded area, mm-hmm. away from the high traffic.
Right.
So it'd be a wonderful place to either raise your family or to build a second home,
mm-hmm.
if you care to do that. But it's a beautiful area.
Very yeah, and we've got financing we can get through it for
right.
you through St. Leonard Homestead
other sources. There are a few of the banks here that will even do 100% financing for land.
Sure.
So we do have that, which that's a plus.
That's a
you know, we
plus
didn't
there.
Have that.
You know what the good thing about Lock the Carlisle is? It's a sleeper. Nobody knows about it.
Right.
I mean, people in Karen Crow and Lafayette. Okay,
right.
What are you, 15, 20 minutes from Lafayette?
But about 15 minutes.
It takes like 45 to 50 minutes to get from Le Triomphe to the Oil Center.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yes.
You can drive from Lock the Carlisle to Lafayette in the morning, in 20 minutes.
That's right. Maximum mm-hmm. of 20 minutes. And we're right off the interstate, so
you're right on I-49.
You have I-49
right.
access.
I mean, you're not right on the interstate,
no.
but I mean,
right.
what is it?
Away
it's less than
about
I'd say maybe
eighth of a mile.
Eighth of a mile away.
Mm-hmm.
so that you're not stuck with listening to that traffic and
right.
all that stuff right on the highway.
Right,
you know?
Right.
You're just far enough to get out of the traffic noise,
right.
but close enough to be right on the interstate. You can jump on the interstate
right.
and go to Lafayette. And I'll tell you, anybody, I mean, we cover a non-parish area with
mm-hmm.
our show.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I'm telling you, folks, if you come look at this property, you're going to fall in
oh,
love
you're gonna
with
love
it.
It.
Beautiful lots.
Beautiful.
They're reasonably priced. I mean, you go
yes.
to anywhere else around
oh.
Lafayette
yes.
and find a place like this, you're going to pay a high dollar.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yeah.
You are. And
pay.
The square footage is very reasonable. It's 1,700 square feet for if you build a home, heat and cool. And of course, you'll have to have a double garage attached to the house.
Mm-hmm.
It is a restricted area, and that's for your benefit to protect your investment.
Mm-hmm. That's correct.
So it is. It's a lovely
We've
area.
We've got underground utilities.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We've got paved streets.
Yes.
Everything's set in place, ready to build. We have one beautiful home that my younger brother built.
Yes.
I mean, it's gorgeous. He's got a wooden walkway. I think the house is probably, 2,800 square feet living.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe a little bigger, but I wouldn't think much bigger than that. It's just a good size house.
It's a beautiful home.
Got a beautiful double car garage, and it's got a nice walkway, a wooden walkway that's, you know, you walk a piece and then you go down a level and walk another piece. And then he's got a pier.
A pier.
He's got a boat. He's got a big fountain out there.
Mm-hmm.
He's got some ducks with a feeder.
Beautiful.
And, it's really pretty.
When I was there last week, I was seeing some of the beautiful cranes and
yeah.
what have you that land
yeah.
there. You get to see the wildlife. It's a,
yeah.
a wonderful setting. You feel like you're at some resort, actually.
Yeah, it really is nice. The other thing is that I saw
club,
some Canadian geese out there.
Mm.
And don't don't forget the country club is right there by the.
That's true.
Yes.
Indian Hills Country Club.
That's
got a
right.
golf course that's
mm-hmm.
how far?
Oh, not far.
A couple
you
of
can
miles.
Almost cross over.
You just get on the service road and go right there.
That's
and
right.
And there's the country club.
Mm-hmm.
So
easy, yeah.
So you got a golf course right close to you.
Yeah,
now, the other
right.
thing is that the good thing that a lot of people like is it stocked with
yes.
Bass and copper nose brim. I stocked it myself about 3 or 4 years ago, and there's some big bass in
there. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
HB went out there and caught 9 bass from 4 to 8 pounds.
Wow.
9 pounds. Mm-hmm. And heck, you get out there in the afternoon after work, fix you a scotch, or if you like to drink, have a drink,
right.
and you throw you a couple of baits and catch you a couple of bass
mm-hmm.
and fillet them right there and put them in the skillet.
That's right.
Mm-hmm.
That's great.
Hey, you put
that's
your little pier out
wonderful.
There.
Wonderful.
You got a little boat.
And that's free.
Mm-hmm.
Don't cost a penny.
That's right. So you can ask for better.
Are there any association fees out there?
Well, you know what we're going to do is we're gonna walk before we run on that deal because once we get enough people in there, I would assume that the people that live in that subdivision would want an association
mm-hmm.
to be able to maintain different things because it's a private road.
Mm-hmm.
Now, there is a possibility of dedicating it to the parish, which we can do.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
But I intentionally have not done that because, you know, I want feedback from the people that live in there.
Mm-hmm.
If they would want to gate that subdivision, they could do that. You
right.
could have a gated subdivision, which is with a code to get in the gate,
sure.
and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So I've been real kind of crawling before I walk on that subject because, you know, I'd like to get a feel out of the people. We have a board.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's me and Pat Morrow and Robert Wolf and maybe HB
mm-hmm.
on the board, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And so we just kind of wait and see what people want, you
right.
know.
Mm-hmm.
I mean,
right.
if they don't want privacy like that, then naturally right now it's private.
It is very private.
We
one
we,
entrance.
You know, we don't have any, but one, I mean, you come in they've got a nice entrance, and you come in, and it's no trespassing, it's
mm-hmm.
private. But, you know, if the people, once we get enough houses in there, people decide to that they want an association and want it private and want to gate it,
mm-hmm.
you know, that'll be something I'll turn over to them, you know.
Right.
Let
right.
the association decide that,
mm-hmm.
don't you think?
Mm-hmm. I think that's mm-hmm. a good idea. Then the people can kind of govern themselves.
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to dictate what they want. You know, I think majority should rule in that deal.
Right.
So we've kind of been slow on going that route.
Mm-hmm.
But it's certainly worth looking at, I'll tell you.
Beautiful property. Mm-hmm. The scenery is gorgeous.
Oh, Lord. And like I said, I have not talked to anyone. I just, some people, every now and then, some of my friends will go right out there and they'll say, goodness gracious, I never knew that.
That's right.
That was out there. Mm-hmm. So it's something you really need to look at if you're interested in building a home or getting away from, you know, I don't like people living right next door to me. Mm-hmm. I mean, I don't. Mm-hmm. I mean, some people got a house that's 5 feet away from
them.
And they got these little yards and stuff. That's not my cup of tea. Mm-hmm. I like to...
Got
a little
space.
Breathing room, you know.
Right.
And these lots are large.
They're large lots.
Large enough to appreciate that kind of thing, and they're not too big to where you can't keep them up.
Right.
You know.
Right.
So, those acreage run how big?
Well, it's a little over 1 acre. I didn't put down the exact amount. I think it was like one.
I think some of them run anywhere from a half to an acre.
From a half to two. Well, the largest one I think was like 1 point. Let's see what we got here.
I'd love to be able to scan this
plat
and put it on the
1.183 is one of the larger lots.
Right.
So
that's 1 3/4.
Basically, yeah. They're running a half acre up between that and 2 acres. And really, the way the lake is designed, and with the gentle rolling hills, you're sitting up on the hill looking down at the lake.
That's right.
Which is really beautiful to see.
Yeah.
Yes. You're not level with the lake. You're kind of looking down.
And Norma, you got a lot of other listings besides this.
Oh, yes, we have other listings, plenty of other listings.
Miss Norma's got listings all over St. Landry Parish and probably.
In Evangeline Parish, Lafayette, St. Martin, a little bit of everywhere.
Yeah, well,
we travel wherever we need to go.
Thank
you.
Thank
you. It's good to be here.
And we'd like to
have a chance. Been hearing about her a lot, but never met her.
Thank you so much.
See you on TV and in the newspaper.
Right.
Yes, indeed.
Folks, our show airs Wednesdays at 7 a.m. and at 6 p.m. It also airs on Thursdays at noon. Nice. Now, you can also Google us at the Sean Dejean Show and catch us on the internet at any time. If you got people that live out of state and want to see us,
I got
they can
a lot
do
of
that.
My cousin look at us on out of state.
We even got our own seasoning. Look. Dejean seasoning. See, you can buy your own seasoning from us.
Talk about
or
good seasoning.
You go to www.kdcg.com and you go to the archives and, you know, you can backlog and get probably 15 to 20 previous shows on our website. So tune in to us next week, and we enjoyed the show. Ms. Norma, thank you for being here.
Thank you for inviting me.
Time, ladies and gentlemen.
And we enjoyed it.